Let's bring in Matt Schlapp, chairman for the American Conservative Union, and Richard Fowler, radio talk show host and Fox News contributor. Gentlemen, thank you for joining us.
Hey,
Matt,
Harris.
I want to start with you because you say this was smart to release those email documents in Twitter. Why?
Yeah, my feeling was as soon as we all read about the fact that this meeting happened, is that my advice to the Trump team all along is to put out all the information, all the emails, all the scheduling items that you have, just, and I would, you know, turn it over to the council. In this case, they were even more democratic and just gave it to all of us. I think it actually is the right thing to do. The only thing to cover here, Harris, is the drip, drip, drip of some other tiny little detail that comes out. There's still nothing to the central charge here. We have a special counsel, not because members of Trump team might have met with somebody who was Russian. We have a special counsel because of this idea that there was somehow inappropriate collusion between the Trump campaign and Vladimir Putin. We are nowhere even in that vicinity, so just put out all these details. Mm. Once they're out, the press has really nothing left to cover.
Well, and Richard, I've heard you say certain things like that, even about the Hillary Clinton campaign. I mean, back when it was going on, you said, you know what, this drip, drip, drip is killing us on the other side of the political aisle.
Yes, I think Matt is 100% right. I think this White House is messy handling this, right? So a couple months ago when this whole thing started, the moment that they announced a special counsel, if I were this White House, I would have had boxes and boxes of papers being pushed out of the West Wing, going to the special counsel's office, and the idea that we're transparent, we're accountable, we want to get it done for the American people. They didn't do that, and so now you have this drip, 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 drip. Now, here's the thing, right? So for Democrats, we're over here talking about treason and collusion, and we're not sure that there's a there yet, but for Republicans, they're saying there's a big nothing burger. This is not a nothing burger. This is a thing. I mean, if you look at this email, the one marked from 420 on June 27, 2016, they say, I've asked to schedule a meeting with you and the Russian government attorney. This is problematic, right? And this also points to the fact that Vice President Mike Pence has been put in harm's way because he said there was never any interaction. And then last month, Don Jr. said that there was never interaction between them and Russians.
So let's go through this.
Let me stop you there because actually, Matt, it is true that there have been members of the Republican Party leading up to this, and including members of the campaign, that had said that there was no sort of meeting or anything going on with Russian officials. I'm still not clear, though, what a crown prosecutor is.
That's
right.
I
don't really know what a link to the Kremlin. I mean, those are some loosey-goosey words that I think you got to drill down on the facts there, which we're not going to do in the next 2.5 minutes. But give me your thoughts.
Yeah, Harris, that's the whole point. That, you know, once again, we have a special counsel because there's this charge that there was collusion with the Russian government to change the outcome of the U.S. presidential election. Now it's turning into people saying, aha, somebody on the Trump team, including one of Trump's sons, met with someone who was Russian. Someone who was Russian who was trying to say, hey, I have close ties to the government. Well, this all gets a little absurd. We even have Democrats saying that this woman potentially is a spy. The New York Times talked about that she had something to do with this bogus dossier that was prepared. You know, my question back to the Obama team is, if she's a spy, what the heck is she doing in the country? It goes back to the same question, which is that it seems like the Obama administration was pretty loose on protecting our election and our cybersecurity, and they're trying to change it to the fact that because Donald Trump Jr. met with someone who was Russian. What matters is this, the underlying charge was there inappropriate or illegal activity on behalf of Team Trump with the Russian government? And to this day, there is still not a scintilla of evidence.
The White House is not doing all it can, though, to push this off the screen yet.
No, they're not, Harrison. Matt, I love you, and that was quite a pivot there.
Oh, so it's love in the afternoon.
But that was quite a pivot.
Richard, I'm not really good on my toes. I don't pivot.
That was a pivot. So to blame this on the Obama administration when the Trump associates met with Russians and decided not to fess up about it.
Why was a woman in this country?
Wait a minute. I'm not a Democrat out there saying this is treason. I'm not a Democrat out there saying that this is impeachable. I'm a Democrat out there saying that there are some questions here and the American people deserve answers on this question. And this White House and anybody involved in the Trump campaign should do everything in their power to make sure that their names are cleared. And what we're seeing is that is not happening.
So, Richard, what we ought to do is we can get to this underlying question of whether there was illegal activity with Team Trump and Russia pretty quickly. We've been talking about this for 8 months. We can put a time limit on this, show and give the American people what you know. And you know what they know? They see there's no evidence of any wrongdoing.
Because
this could all
drip,
come
drip,
to an end
coming
pretty
from
soon.
This White House.
That's interesting.
Don Jr. knew that he met with this Russian official, but it comes out months after this investigation started. That's where the problem lies.
Richard Fowler applauds Don Jr. I love it.
You guys having all sorts of aha moments. I had an aha moment a few minutes ago when Senator Kennedy said, with more optimism than I've heard since Santa promised me a bike, that we're going to see health care get voted on next week. And so if we continue to talk about Russia, can we multitask and also get some other things done? That's the big question on Capitol Hill. Have you heard the Senate is going to stay for longer in August? A lot of news going on, gentlemen. Glad to have you. Thank you.
Good to be here.